Welcome to Detroit Sports Jersey Media, Sundays from 11 a.m. to noon, broadcasting live from Detroit and stretching to the heart of Central Texas, here on FM 88.1 WHPR with co-hosts Longhorn and the Jersey Girl. Straight sports talk, no professionals here. And now, here's your host that never gets it right but is never wrong, Will Sims.
Woo! All right, welcome to Detroit Sports Jersey. I'm your host, Will. Jersey Girl is out today due to her birthday. We have Haley sitting next to me.
Happy birthday, Jersey Girl.
Yeah, happy birthday to you. And Longhorn, what time is it also joining us?
Game time, prime time, Detroit Sports Jersey Media time. What's up, Haley? Happy birthday, Jersey Girl, in his house. We got the baddest sports team in the land, in the universe. Let's get it on.
Why you always give these Martin Luther King long speeches?
Because I have a dream one day.
All right, welcome to
the Lions win the Super Bowl.
All right, whatever. Anyway, welcome to the pregame show. We got the Lions in Minnesota today. We're going to touch on that. Also, Haley comments coming up later. What do you have to talk about today in Haley's comments?
Oh, what is a good man, Detroit? What do you think a good man is?
What?
What is a good man? You heard a Longhorn. You nervous? You don't fall under that category?
No, because I'm an excellent one. Now, how you like them apples?
All right, now you done raised it up a little bit, huh?
All right. I raised the bar, brother.
You know, I noticed one thing about the Jersey Girl, right? I know it's her birthday, and I ain't trying to rain her on her parade, but she never show up after the Lions lose.
You notice that?
I was thinking about that today when she texted me. I was like, you know, I understand it's your birthday. You want to celebrate. She actually said her family cooked her a big breakfast this morning, which was cool and everything. But I started thinking, you know, she never shows up after the Lions lose.
Can we see a pattern?
So I'm assuming she's not going to be showing up for the next 15 weeks. But anyway, Longhorn, what happened to your Detroit Lions last week? They was up 21-3 against the Chargers. They blew it.
Longhorn. Well, I'm going to keep it 100. You know, I watched the game with my eyes, not with my heart. So I'm going to keep it 100. I'm going to keep it real with you. I'm a Lions fan. You know, I don't go on hopes and dreams. When they were up 21-10, I looked at my buddy.
Longhorn, it was 21-3. Longhorn, it was 21-3. They was up.
I'm talking about when they were up 21-10.
Okay.
In the third quarter, I looked at my buddy and I said, "You know what? We're gonna lose this game." And my buddy looked at me and said, "Man, have faith in your team, brother." I said, "Look, number one, the Lions are not gonna keep this lead. I feel it in the crust of my bones. Number two, the defense, unlike the defense of last year, is not, they're not going to hold the Chargers back. So we're going to lose this game. I'm trying to tell you. I bet the bank on it. And the offense is not going to score. I said, we need to at least get two more touchdowns to win this game. We need to have a 35-10 score before the third quarter is out to win this game."
Look, they let San Diego come back and score 30 straight points.
Yeah.
30 straight points. And actually, let me give you some fuzzy numbers here.
Here we go, the fuzzy numbers.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to give you these fuzzy numbers because you was the one screaming, "Good riddance to Sue." The defense gave up 483 yards. So are you still going to echo that same statement, "Good riddance to Sue"? The defense
I'm going to echo it off Mount Everest, because the reason why I was saying "good riddance to Sue" is because a lot of Lions fans didn't want to give. See, I'm going on the flip side of the defense and the Sue era, because a lot of Lions fans kept trying to tell me that it was the offense and not just the defense. And I kept telling them, no, it was only the defense that was keeping us in those games. So when I was saying "good riddance to Sue," if you look back on the tapes and the shows, it's because I was saying, now I want to see what type of really offense that we have. And now we see that the offense is boo-boo. The offense cannot hold a lead.
Okay, well, it wasn't the offense that lost the game. It was the defense. They gave up 30 straight points. The offense didn't give up those points.
Brother, you mean to tell me we are 21-3, 21-10, and your offense cannot score two more touchdowns?
Hold on. Whoa. If you up 21-10 in the third quarter, as you put it, you mean to tell me your defense can't stop their offense for another quarter?
Well, I'm an offensive-minded type
okay,
guy.
Okay, well, offense win games.
We need to just score, keep running up the tally on the points.
Okay, well, you know the statement, offense win games, defense win championships.
Well, obviously, our offense did not win that game. So, so now we know the real deal.
I mean, we can throw it out there if somebody want to call in and disagree or agree with the Longhorn, 313-868-3688. Now, Longhorn, you got Minnesota today. This is a must-win game. I know it's early in the season, but this is a must-win game.
I don't see us starting off no 0-5. We cannot go 0-2. If we go 0-2, then it's some flim-flammery in that mix right here.
I'm going to tell you why, Longhorn, why this is a must-win game. You seen the Thursday night game. Everybody thought Peyton Manning was washed up.
Oh, man. Oh,
okay, that's your next opponent.
He did his due right there.
That's your next opponent. Nets Sunday night. Excuse me. Nets Sunday night. That's your opponent. The Broncos come into town. That's your home opener. The chances of you winning that game are slim and none. Yet you had a wonderful home record last year, but that's last year. After that, you travel to Seattle. So you got the possibility of starting 0-4. So this is a must-win game today.
Oh, yes, a must-win game, especially when you got Manning coming in with two touchdowns in 32 seconds. He just throw the two-minute clock out the window. Two touchdowns in 32 seconds. Are you serious? Hey, even my mama was telling me about that. Did you see the did you see that 32 seconds?
No.
There's not even enough time for a commercial break. Commercials are normally only 30 seconds.
But see that, and I'm glad you brought that situation up. See that, remember the, was it last year, the year before last? Was it last?
Okay, go ahead. Yep, I know you're getting ready to say.
Yep, remember the Dallas game?
Yeah.
And they took the pass away from Calvin Johnson?
Yep.
Now you see what your boy Peyton Manning did the other night. Right, how many seconds and how many minutes was left? And he came back and won.
So why couldn't Stafford do that?
And they had over 2 minutes left in that game. That's why I'm trying to tell the Lions fans, your quarterback sucks. He's not an elite quarterback.
No, but I will say one thing about the Lions, that game, and I did like Amir. Amir got off.
Yeah, he had 199.
He was a bright spot in that game for me.
Yeah, he had 199 all-purpose yards. So, yeah, he's as a rookie, he came through, as you know.
He got off. He's on my some of my buddies. I told him to put him on his fantasy football on their running back, and he got them some points. So, Amir got off in that game. I'm proud of the young man.
I'm telling you right now, the defense lost that game. Simple as that. I'm not no big Stafford fan, but I'm not going to put this game right here on the offense. I think the offense, yeah, they could have scored some more points, but if you up 21-3, there's no reason why we should. Your defense should have stepped up and stopped their offense. Simple as that. San Diego was giving them that game, but you turn around, what happened? Fumble, turnover, interception, turnover. You know what I'm saying? Boom, we back in the game. Simple as that. The defense should have stepped up. This is where you miss Sue, and this is where you miss Fairley. Now, Jersey okay. Girl, I know
speaking
you...
Of Sue, speaking ahead. Of Sue, I don't want to get off the subject right fast, but speaking of Sue, what do you think they down there, they talking about Sue knee that guy in the head?
Oh, that was just a misunderstanding.
I don't think there was no knee in the head. I think there was an accident.
It was clearly an accident. You know, but you know, your reputation, when you get a bad reputation like that, it follows you around wherever you go, no matter what you do in life. If you have a bad reputation and something jumps off, your reputation. I mean, it's even though it could have been an accidental mistake, basically your reputation just, you know, trumps that. So of
course, I looked at the video over and over again. I got my text. They came in and looked at the video, and you know, I had people who analyzed the video, and to me, that did not look like any type of knee in the head. It like he just got up, walked away, and to me, it looked like the guy on the ground did some acting. So you couldn't even tell what a guy hit in the head from the angle of the camera. You couldn't tell what really happened. So I think they're just trying to trump it up and make more of it than it would appear to be. So.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, it's his reputation. It's as simple as that. Of course it was an accident. He didn't do that on purpose.
I don't even think he did anything.
You know.
I think it was just the way the camera angle looked like something happened. That guy on the ground just threw his head back. He did an old head flop.
If he didn't have the reputation that he had, this would not be an issue. It's as simple as that.
Yeah, that's true.
It's as simple as that. I mean, you got other players out there doing that, you know, accidentally, you know, making, you know, doing the same thing, Sue doing a similar, but they don't have the reputation, and so far the media is not going to focus on that. But if you have the reputation, it's going to follow you. His reputation is going to follow him throughout his career, that him being a dirty player. It's as simple as that. No matter what he do, he's going to always be labeled a dirty player until he comes play for your team.
And so, That's right.
So, therefore, if the fans, until he plays for your team, that label is going to always carry out with him throughout his career. But let's break down this game today with Minnesota Longhorns, because you picked the Lions last week to blow out. Man, my voice is going, but...
Yeah, your voice is blowing out, too.
And I told y'all, I picked the Chargers. You and the Jersey girl picked the Lions to win. They let you guys down. Y'all cried all week, you know. See, that's why people ask me why I'm not a Lions fan, because I like to have a happy Sunday.
Oh, my God. Hey.
So let's break this game down today, Longhorn. They up in Minnesota. Adrian Peterson didn't look good last week. Teddy Bridgewater looks so-so. Now, this is supposed to be the season where they take the giant step in, you know, having a great team. Now, granted, Adrian Peterson only touched the ball 10 times for 31 yards. I think this week he's going to have over 20, 25 carries. And I think basically he's going to run all over the Lions defense. Because I'm looking at it like this. If they couldn't stop the Chargers offense, I don't really see them stopping Adrian Peterson, who, by the way, has 12 touchdowns in 12 career games against the Detroit Lions. Tell me what you feel about today's game, Longhorn.
Well, I think today's game is going to be I think the Lions – I'm going to go with you on the Lions defense. I think the cornerbacks on the Lions are going to have a tough defense. Tough time covering the receivers this game for Minnesota. So I'm going to go with the Lions. They're not going to pull this one out. You know, I'm going to go with my eyes and logic. I'm not going to go with my heart. So – Any Lions fans out there who think I'm a turncoat or a traitor, I'm just going to keep it real. We're going to lose this game, and I'm going to say we're going to lose it by, I hate to say this, Lions then, but I think we're going to lose it by 14. No. It's not going to be a close game. Amir, he's going to get off, like I said. Yeah. Stafford, he's going to get sacked quite a few times. I see that in the cards. Peterson's going to get off. So, I think the Lions are going to lose this. We're going to go 0-2.
You are and, not
Lions needless to say, sorry to say, we're going to start the season off 0-4. I just feel for my man Carwell. Hopefully they don't try to run him out of town because of this bad break in the season that we starting off as 0-4. So I'm just going to keep it real, keep it 100, and keep it moving. So,
Haley, what
but
did
I
you
still
just...
say we can go 11-5.
Longhorn.
So only got one more game to lose. So I don't know what's going to happen at the end of this season.
Is that mic on?
Yes.
All
right.
So let me get this straight. You're a Lions fan, but you're doubting that they're going to lose.
No, I'm not doubting they're going to lose. I'm saying they're going to lose.
Well, You're not a Lions fan then. How are you going to be? You're supposed to rep the team to the end. If they lose, they win. Good or bad, rain or sunshine.
He be fronting, Haley.
How are you going to say that you're this big Lions fan, but yet you're saying, you're predicting how many points they're going to lose by? You are not a real fan. You just gotta
that's a real fan. A real fan.
No. A real fan.
A real fan is a fan through thick and thin. Not right. Through the just the good times. Not a fair weather fan.
Right, but that's a positive real fan.
Looks at the game with their eyes and logic. A fair weather fan sits there and you can see your team losing by 100 points and then say, don't worry, we're going to come back. Are you serious? There's only 2 seconds left in the game and we're down
by 50
points.
But you're already predicting that they're going to lose. They haven't even played. You're predicting that they're going to lose. And how do you know if they're going to lose?
She got a good point there, Longhorn.
Oh, my God.
It'd be different if they were playing the game and then you're like, oh, okay, well, they're going to lose. But they haven't even played the game and you're just predicting, oh, 15 points, they're going to lose by that point. I'm sorry.
Point well taken.
Not really sorry. You know how people say stuff like, well, you know, I'm not trying to be rude, but it didn't say something rude. That's the same thing you did. Well, I'm not saying that I'm not a diehard Lions fan, but they're going to lose by 15 points against the other opponent.
Read him his rights, Haley. I love it. Go ahead, Longhorn. What you got to say?
Oh my God.
Yeah, I mean, come on. Well, point Haley. Well taken, Longhorn. I mean, she got a good point. The game, they ain't even took the field yet, and you done predicted, and you're supposed to be a true Lions fan, that they're going to lose by 14.
Oh my God. Hey.
Wait a minute. What kid, man, you know what? You brought up a good point. And this is the same guy that said they going to the Super Bowl.
Not going with those actions and thoughts to going to the Super Bowl.
Oh my God.
Maybe you should suit up and help them win the game then.
Yeah, he gonna suit up like he's supposed to be getting you that music you play for your intro.
He did. He sent it to me, but it wasn't the right.
Did you listen to it?
Yeah, maybe it would be something good for you.
What song was it?
It was like some Superman instrumental beat. I don't know. I listened to it.
Matter of fact, I want you. I talked to the guy, the DJ, and he asked me to ask you, what did you want to listen? What would you like? To send me some titles of songs that you like.
You know, and Classic Man.
And hook it up for you. So now I'm waiting on you to send me some
classic
music that
man.
You would like, the title that you would like.
You're not
and
listening.
And then he'll square your way and hook it up for you.
You're not listening. Classic Man, you know, I'm a classic man. It plays on the radio. I know it plays down there in Texas. It's by.
Oh, I know what song you're talking about. Do you like that song?
Yep.
Okay, so we got you then.
Because I'm a classic. Not that super. I don't know where you got that from. You probably got that from, like, YouTube or something. Nice try. I appreciate it. But see, you're going to try a little bit harder, just like with the Lions, you know?
Point well taken.
Oh, I know this guy, point well taken, who drops his team because they drop a coach.
Whoa. I didn't drop my team because they fired the coach. I dropped the team because the owners are idiots and the GM's an idiot. Now,
so
granted,
you drop your team because they dropped it because the owners are idiots. You're going to drop a team.
Yes.
A team that you've been with for lifelong history.
I can't support it. Them being idiots like that. I'm sorry. I can't support people being idiots. I just can't condone that. Now, granted, they won last week. I give them that. You know, but I just can't support. I'm sorry. I got a 49ers pen in my hand. I'm sitting here on the desk, and I will keep using it till the ink runs out.
Oh, Lord. And look, don't let them win no Super Bowl, and I won't hear you say nothing about, I used to be a 49ers fan. I've got my jersey back on, and when they get to the cream, when the cream rises back to the top, don't start hollering how you a 49ers fan either.
It'll never
happen. That's the difference between me and a fair weather fan of the Detroit Lions. You know, I keep it real. When I say we're gonna lose, I'm still a Lions fan.
So
when we go to the top,
how can you
I'm
still
gonna
be
a Lions fan,
if
but
you
I'm
know
keeping
they're
it
gonna,
real.
Gonna lose. I mean, you know when you're a fan they're gonna lose, but you're saying predicting they're gonna lose. I know in my heart that the Lions, even though I'm a fan and I just rah rah Lions this and defend the Lions, How are you going to defend the Lions and you're saying they're going to lose?
It's just like going to see an artist and you saying you hate him, but yet you still go see him.
I didn't say I hate the Lions.
I mean.
Well, you're acting like you do.
Oh, my God.
Lions, you got to find a different rep person because Longhorn is doing you no justice. He's making Detroit doubt you because we are on a radio show and you're saying how you love them, but they suck. That's basically what you're saying.
I didn't say they suck. I said I love the Lions. I'm a diehard Lions fan. But I know the writing is on the wall.
Listen.
And I know what ones we're working with.
You just dig it.
It's sort of like, if I'm going out there and we playing a team, I have a peewee football.
We're going to win. When you start thinking negative, that's when negative things happen. You can't say, because it's 50 of them.
Haley, if the outcome comes like I say, then you're going to say it's because of me?
No, what she's saying, don't be no motivational speaker. What we're going to do, we're going to take a quick commercial break. And when we come back, we're going to do some more NFL talk. We'll be back after a word from our sponsor.
A head that's as smooth as a billiard ball, don't settle for anything less than a Cobra razor. Because it's designed to comfortably transform from a face-shaving razor to a head-shaving razor with just the click of a button. Treat your head to the closest shave you can imagine at CobraRazors.com. Cobra Razors, for a head that's as smooth as you are.
Hello, Detroit Sports Jersey listeners. If you would like to be a sponsor of Detroit Sports Jersey, the email address is info@DetroitSportsJersey.com. And the phone number is 313-624-7814. We air every Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern on FM 88.1 WHPR with live streaming at FM 88.1 WHPR.com. Detroit Sports Jersey offers reasonable sponsorship rates. Detroit Sports Jersey is sponsored by ENO Productions /Fiverr. That's F-I-V-E-R-R. ENO Productions /Fiverr does video production work, and this is where Detroit Sports Jersey goes for video work week after week. Again, that's ENO Productions /Fiverr. That's F-I-V-E-R-R.
Yeah. All right, we're back. Detroit Sports Jersey in studios with Haley Scott and the Longhorn. What time is it, Longhorn?
Hello?
Longhorn, you still there? Well, we don't
know. Game time, prime time, Detroit.
He done got mad and hung up. Is that what the problem is? He got called out. You still there, Longhorn?
Oh, I'm still here.
Well, speak up, man. Say something. Quit crying. We were just joking with you. All
right. Game time, prime time. Detroit Sports Jersey Media time. And it's the Lions. Let's get it on.
313-868-3688. Hey, check this out, Longhorn. Let me ask you a question. As a matter of fact, I'm going to ask you and Haley this. Y'all know Russell Wilson dating Sierra, right? Especially you, Haley. I'm going to get your opinion on this since you of the younger generation. You know, he done banned, you know, of course, Sierra done had a baby with Future, right? Mm-hmm. Now, how do you feel about him banning all of Future's music at the practice and at game day? Is that being childish or...
He done banned the music.
Yeah, can't nobody play none of Future's music as long as he around at practice or on game day.
Who banned it?
Russell Wilson, the quarterback. He's dating Sierra, which Future had a baby by Sierra. So supposedly, you know, they got a little
beef.
Yeah, you know, they going back and forth, you know.
Well, first of all, that's petty because Future is a good artist and his football team, his teammates are not the only ones that listen. So if he goes out to a park or something and somebody in their car playing Future, he gonna tell them to cut it off because he don't want to listen to it. I mean, it's just kind of like, it's okay, I get the little beef. But come on, man. Y'all need to be thinking together and see how both y'all can make some money. Future play his songs and he get paid. And Russell, how that can help you as well. That's how I would be thinking about it.
Well, unfortunately, we don't do that. We can't come together. Yeah, we can't.
Wait a minute. Let me get this straight. Wilson has banned Future's music from being played
at practice and on game day from the players and anybody associated with the Seahawks.
Wilson.
Yep. So obviously he got some juice up there.
The player.
The quarterback. We're talking about the same player, man. You can break it down however you want to. Yes.
I'm just saying a player has banned somebody's music from being played.
For the 100th time, yes.
I'm like, dog, brother, who are you to ban people's music? What's wrong with this dude, man?
Obviously, he got that juice up in Seattle. He banned it. You know,
obviously, this guy, you know, I thought this guy had, you know what, man? His ratings with me had done, and it's only because of
you don't like him. Now you don't like him no more, huh?
No, man, that's stupid, man.
How many future albums do you have?
You gonna go and ban somebody's music because of Ciara? Are you serious?
Well, it ain't so much about her. It's because them two got a little, you know, riff going on, a little beef, as the young folks would say today. When y'all gonna come up with something? What else is it out there besides beefing?
What are y'all gonna come up with?
Who?
Here's something stupid.
Stupid.
Yeah, how's that sound? Stupid. He gonna ban her music because they got some stupid going on.
You know how
Come on, Wilson. Are you? I mean, you gonna go down to kid playground level? You gonna go all the way back to playground level with this type of stuff? Man, you a multi-millionaire. You know what I'm saying? Supposed to be grown folks, and you gonna talk about, oh, you can't play his music because he got something going on with my woman. You know, this little stupidity thing, Russell. Your stats are going down. Two thumbs down for you, bro. I thought you had more maturity than that. And I wish you would ban me from playing that music. You know, just like Haley said, you go out to the park and somebody pumping on music. What, you going to walk over to my car talking about, oh, you can't play that music? Man, this dude is stupid.
Well, see.
Two thumbs down.
See, if you was his teammate, Longhorn, you wouldn't be saying that.
You would be like, all right, bro.
You know, because one thing, all you don't want to have no riff going on in the locker room with something you really don't have nothing to do with anyway. And they're not that serious, exactly. And a lot of them guys.
It's not that serious, but for real, Will, for real. If he came in the locker room and said, all right, you guys, from now on, nobody plays my man music because this, and the third. Now, you know, me and you, if we're on his team, we look at each other and we look and say, this dude is stupid. Now to keep
you
it real.
You would do it, though.
When we look at each other, this dude is stupid. Music, seriously, dog?
You
seriously.
Would do it. You would do it just because one is petty. You don't want to cause a problem.
I know.
Your
I know we would do it.
You'll lose.
Now, keeping it real, even Haley, wouldn't you be in the locker room looking at like, this dude is stupid?
Well, yeah, I'd be like, you're an idiot, but all right, I just still want to win and I don't want to get suspended. So, all right, bro.
Yeah, because you know what's going to happen. Soon we pump the music in the locker room. He gonna go up and tell and get us suspended, right?
Well, there ain't no much probably getting you suspended. I mean,
yes, he would.
It depends. Like, well, first of all,
let me give you a point against my wishes, okay, and I'm the captain of the team.
Okay, whoa, whoa.
Suspend Will, Haley, and Longhorn.
No. Let me tell you, put it to you like this. It depends on what your status is on the team. For example, let's say Richard Sherman plays his music. There's nothing Russell Wilson can do about it.
Yeah, nothing. Yeah, there's nothing he can do about him.
Because of his status on the team, he's a great player. Like I'm saying, but if you're the 50th man, 55 man on the team, second string, third string, yeah, your days will be numbered there.
what do you think would happen if Sherman just pumped it up anyway?
Nothing. Because of his status on the team. Let's say Beast Mode played it. Marshawn Lynch. Nothing would happen.
So would you think that would be them? So what do you think Wilson would look at them like, oh, man, y'all disrespecting me?
I don't know what he would say, but nothing happened to the players. Nothing.
That's what I'm saying. That's stupid, man. You're going to say don't play that music because there's something stupid going on between the dude and his wife and his girl. Now,
man, it's golly, out for
that's soap opera.
It made the news.
Playground type of crap, man. You talking about the NFL, man? This, golly, they're gonna turn into the WWE up in the locker room.
Right? Are you okay over there?
No. I mean,
okay.
I'm gonna let it go.
All right, Longhorn. Let's touch on this SEC. You want to talk about a little college football? Let's switch gears here so you can calm down.
Yeah, I need to take a...
Because people want to know, how many future albums do you have, or CDs, or 45s, or whatever you still listen to, cassette tapes? I mean...
Real to real. I got real to real.
All right, Longhorn, let's touch on this SEC. You want to bring it up. Go ahead and let the people know. We talking college football now. What's the...
The SEC. I just want to touch on that because I got some diehard fans down here of the SEC, and they were talking a lot of smack about all the SEC this, SEC this, especially when the college championship games is going on, and, you know, a lot of people talking about they need to change it to the SEC championship. Until, of course, Ohio went up there and blew it out and won the championship. And, you know, when Bama started out this year and they won their game, of course, Bama lost to Ole Miss. Woohoo! Good riddance. And I know you was crying in your Crimson Tide drink, you know, this weekend. Sorry to hear that, Will. Condolences to you and your team. You know, your Bamaville, Nick Saban, you know, and all that type of stuff. But I tell everybody it's all about the Big Ten, and they better recognize the Big Ten is going to take it again this year. So the SEC is not like it used to be, and that's my word on that. That's the Longhorn.
Actually, I have to agree with you, Longhorn, for the simple fact I'm trying to find these notes that I had in this fish wrap here. But
he brought old fish wrap in.
Yeah, but actually, it's funny that you want to touch on that because I believe in the last 2 years in the playoffs and in bowl games, actually the SEC is 0-5. So you tell your boys down there that it do look kind of bad for them in the SEC as far as winning bowl games and championship games.
Telling you too. You
an
Alabama fan?
Yeah, I'm an Alabama fan. They let me down yesterday. You know, I was a little disappointed, you know.
Yeah, I was surprised you came to work today, but it's all good.
Well, see, I can face my music. I have tough skin. You know, I really do. I have tough skin, so, you know, I'm not like Jersey Girl where I sit every loss out. I can't even find it. But, yeah, but anyway, I just want to touch on that. So let's take another quick commercial break. When we come back, we're going to jump off into some Haley comics and got a lot of more sports things to get to today. Longhorn, did you check out that WNBA stats?
Oh, yeah. Let's get off into that. There's some good news about that WNBA and it's some bad news, but we got a lot of good news about that also.
You know what? Before we go to a commercial break, let's touch on that because the reason I'm bringing that up, right, and you say that's some good news, so you know you don't hit a nerve with me.
Oh, Lord.
Because the NBA commissioner has said, because, you know, they're a product of the, you know, it's like, you know, big brother, little sister type thing, you know, WNBA. Yeah. Now, the NBA commissioner, Adam Silver, says that he thought that the WNBA would have been, you know, would have had a breakthrough by now. Obviously, they're struggling. So what numbers do you have to contradict what he's saying?
Since you said there's some good news. On that part, as far as breakthrough goes. Okay, let me give you some quick fuzzy numbers. Okay, since 2015, you know, as far as attendance goes, you know, they have the lowest average. The average per game is only 7,318. You know, that's the lowest in history. Okay. The greatest average was 10,864, and that was in 1998. They haven't topped the average of 10,000 per game since 2009. However, on the good side of it, they've had 33 sellouts this year, and that's 25 more than last year. And the Phoenix Mercury, they have all-time leading in average of 9,946 visitors per game with 9 sellouts this year. So that's only good news is they had 33 more sellouts than they did last year. Only had 25. So the WNBA is not doing as well as they thought it would be. And a lot of the NBA teams are supplementing their losses. You know, because like you said, it's supposed to be a big brother, little sister relationship. So a lot of the teams are suffering, and the NBA is trying to pick up the slack. And I think, personally, I think I like watching the WNBA. Because to me, it's a little bit more controlled basketball as far as passing and shooting goes. But I think there's the reason it's suffering because you don't have all that above-the-rim, high-flying, you know, and the pace is not as fast as the NBA.
Okay. So, okay, speaking of messed up numbers, this is a person who has some messed up numbers in his supposedly last fight, Floyd Mayweather.
Oh, not that dude.
Nah. The pay-per-view was tremendously down. It sucked. I mean, you know, the Pacquiao fight, he had 4.6 million pay-per-view people to watch the game. This is his last fight. Now, there's some, you know, people saying between 400,000 and
550,000. So, Pacquiao, right?
No, no, no. This last fight he just had, Pacquiao fight, he had 4.6 million.
Right. Oh, this is it's only in the hundreds of thousands of this one, right?
Yeah, 400,000 to 550,000, you know.
Wow.
Yeah, so that lets you know he couldn't sucker 4 more million people out of money like they did in that Pacquiao fight. We're going to take a quick commercial break. When we come back, we're going to get into Haley comments. What's your topic again, Haley?
What is a good man?
All right, Haley. All right, now we'll be back.
For a head that's as smooth as a billiard ball, don't settle for anything less than a Cobra razor. Because it's designed to comfortably transform from a face-shaving razor to a head-shaving razor with just the click of a button. Treat your head to the closest shave you can imagine at CobraRazors.com. Cobra Razors, for a head that's as smooth as you are.
Hello, Detroit Sports Jersey listeners. If you would like to be a sponsor of Detroit Sports Jersey, the email address is info@DetroitSportsJersey.com. And the phone number is 313-624-7814. We air every Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern on FM 88.1 WHPR with live streaming at FM881WHPR.com. Detroit Sports Jersey offers reasonable sponsorship rates. Detroit Sports Jersey is sponsored by ENO Productions /Fiverr. That's F-I-V-E-R-R. ENO Productions /Fiverr does video production work, and this is where Detroit Sports Jersey goes for video work week after week. Mm-hmm. Again, that's ENO Productions /Fiverr. That's F-I-V-E-R-R.
This is where Detroit Sports Jersey goes.
Okay.
All right. Detroit Sports Jersey is sponsored by...
All right, welcome back to Detroit Sports Jersey. I'm your host, Will, sitting up here with Haley Scott. What's going on, Haley?
Nothing much. Excited to talk about this awesome topic today.
All right, we're about to jump off into Haley's comics and Longhorn. What time is it?
Game time, prime time. Detroit Sports Media time. Let's get it on.
All right, Haley, what's your topic for
all
today?
All right, so Detroit, I want to, me and Will was talking before the show, you know, just ask him, you know, like, what do you think I should do for today's show? So he was telling me I seen this, like, this post on Facebook, right?
And, yes.
Yeah, so basically how there was a woman on there just talking about how she can't find a good man and what a good man should be, but when you scroll on her pictures, she was half naked. So I'm like, awesome! That is perfect, 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 because that is what people are. Women, especially, are always complaining about how they can't find them a good man. What do you think a good man is, Will? Since you're a man, what is it? What do you think?
Well, I actually think a good man is a man that's gonna do what he say he's gonna do and handle his responsibility and step up to the plate. Far as, you know, taking care of his family, if he has a family, and also respecting a lady as a lady.
Exactly.
You know, that's the main thing you have to do. You know, you have to respect ladies. You know, if you want a lady, you're going to have to respect a lady. You know, also a good man to me is someone, you know, that puts time and patience into a relationship. Because every relationship has its ups and downs. You know, you just can't, because you and your woman have an argument, you can't run out here in the streets and go sleep with your ex or whoever, you know, you want to sleep just because y'all had an argument. You have to stand strong.
Preach.
You know what I'm saying? Pass the collection plate. But anyway. But basically, it's not really hard, you know, to be a good man. It just take a lot of work to be one. It's, you know, it's not hard. You know, you have to have honesty, integrity. You know, all that good stuff comes with that. You know, you got to be raised right, you know. We was raised right, you know. Mama raised us right to respect women. You know, we had up and down relationships.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm telling you something else, too. Don't nothing really come good out of whether you're a man or a woman meeting someone at the club, and then you sleep with them the same night, and then you expect this person to be this good man or a woman when they done slept with you on the first night. And far as the young lady that was on Facebook, you know, when I saw that poster, it's hard to find a good man out here. But when I look at your photos, you in your panties and your bras, and yeah. I mean, what good man would want to settle down with that? I wouldn't.
Not especially not a woman that respect herself.
Exactly. So that's my definition of a good man, just to sum it up like
that.
That's
right.
You know. So let's get jump before we jump to the long haul. Let's ask you, what do you define a good man as? You know.
Honestly, I don't know. No, I'm just kidding. No, just being young. Like, these guys nowadays are just off the chain. Like, they think if they got money, ice, take you to Benihana's. Personally, I don't even like Benihana's. I think it's overrated. I like regular Chinese food, you know. We can get a box of pizza, and I'm cool, you know. But, you know, guys think if they tell females, like, oh, baby, I drive a Benz and I'm, you know, I do money, I get hustle, and I got ice and this and Giuseppe and Jordans and Gucci's and blah, blah, blah. All this stuff that I don't get impressed by that because it's just like, I don't care because personally, you're not giving that stuff to me. You're not benefiting me. I still have to figure out how I'm going to pay this bill, how I'm going to get there and back to work and all this other stuff and make sure that myself, I'm good first. Well, I don't care if you have Gucci and Louis, that's fine. And personally, a man that has all that stuff, he doesn't flaunt it. A lot of these females that are my age nowadays, they just love the Gucci lifestyle. I don't understand why. I don't know if it's because they make them feel like they're in a music video. I personally don't know. But these guys, young guys nowadays, they take that to the head, you know. Because then they feel like, well, I took you out to eat and I picked you up in my nice car and we smoked the blunt or got some liquor or got a bottle of Patron or whatever. And now you're supposed to give up the goodies. And it's like, hold up. I can buy all that stuff myself. So I feel like a good man is very rare.
So basically, materialistic stuff don't impress you.
No, it's not. You're going to have to come a little bit more than that, baby. Yeah. The materialistic, because do you have good credit? I'm sorry. That's what I ask. I have a list that I have when I meet a guy. Do you have respect for yourself, women, family? Do you have a job? And if you don't have a job, do you have goals? If you don't have no goals, like, I want to be eventually have my own radio show and be famous and take care of my mom and my grandma. If you don't have no future goals, like, I want to be here in life and this is what I want to do, then I can't mess with you, bro. Sorry. Like,
I hear you.
If you don't have, we can't both not have good credit.
If you don't have no directions, you lost.
I'm sorry. Like, you can't be having Gucci, driving a nice car, but you stay with your mama. Like, I'm no thanks. I'm good.
All right, Longhorn. What is a good man to you?
Well, I would like to start off with integrity. Integrity and honesty. Hard working. Haley hit it right on the head. You got to have goals. You got to have goals in life. And for those guys going around and trying to be all flash in the pan, flash and dash, you know, some of that stuff they got flashing that so-called ice. Some of that stuff fire costume jewelry anyway. Some of that zirconia stuff. real fake. Some of them Gucci this, Gucci that. You can go get them knockoffs. You know what I'm saying? So that stuff probably fake too. Someone riding around with them rims on. Rims are probably rented. You know, pay as you go rims. Like you said about them hoopties. You know, rims cost more than they cars. And as far as riding around and trying to get girls, hey, smoke this blunt and drink this liquor with me. So basically, if you got time to smoke blunts, drink liquor all day, every day, and then, you know, say so. If you're telling me you're doing that, then obviously your goals are being pushed to the side, because if you're a real goal-oriented person, if your goal is to smoke blunts and get liquored up every day, then you must be, so you're on your goal path. But if your goal is to try to get education and do some things in your life, then I don't see you getting your education if you're high and drunk every day. So that's not a goal-oriented person to me.
That's
so
true.
Honesty. And you got to look at the person. You know, my thing is this. If you look at the man, how he treats his mama.
Yes, that's exactly what I was about to say. Yes.
How he treats his mama is how he's going to treat you.
All
you know,
right.
I know when we was growing up, you know, my mom used to tell us, I was walking with a girl one time, she hollered out the window, hey, you supposed to be walking on the outside.
That is
that
right.
That girl on the sidewalk. And, you know, I'm like,
you're talking about the one
why should I walk on the outside, walking on the sidewalk with her?
You talking about the one you tripped that time?
What? The one of what?
Nothing. Go ahead.
And her answer to me was, in case a car come up over the curb, it'll hit me and won't hit her.
Exactly.
Hold on. Wait a minute now, Mom.
That's true.
I want to live, too.
But that was my reason. That's what I told her. I was supposed to be on the outside walking on. You know, that's the proper way to walk, you know, on the outside. Number one, you got to look at manners and chivalry. You know, I opened up the door for my wife, you know, as long as I got on hands, you know, she never have to open up the door for when she's going inside. You know, car door, no matter where it is.
I don't know.
You know, same thing for my daughter. I open up the door for my daughter and I tell her, you know, guys got to open up the door for ladies. That's the way it is. That's the way it's going to be.
You know what?
When she start dating, a guy better not come blowing their horn.
I know that's right.
Guy
got to
come up to the door and meet me. You know what I'm saying? Those are things that, you know, make up a good man. These are things that guys need to be taught. You know what I'm saying?
But see, the thing
honesty, integrity, trust. You know what I'm saying?
But it's Longhorn. And, it's the thing about all that, the opening up the doors and the blowing of the car horn, the reason they do that because women accept that.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? They'll run out there, jump in the car. You know what I'm saying? Now, holding open the car doors, you know what they call it? You the chirp guy. You the chirp female. You know where you hit the unlock button on your key ring. Instead of them walking over there and holding up the door. Let me tell you something about opening up the door. You know, I actually got cussed out one time by this female because I held the door. I think I was going in a store or
like
a restaurant.
I can do it myself.
She said, I don't need you holding the door open for me. I can do it myself. You're right. That's exactly what she said. And I'm like, hey, excuse me. You know, mm-hmm. I'm sorry. Didn't mean, you know, I even got cussed out one time because I told this lady asked me a question. And I was like, I think I said no, ma'am, or yes, ma'am. I know that was my answer.
It's ma'am, I'm not
and she,
old.
And yeah, that's exactly what she said. Do you know these people?
I know women.
Yeah, exactly. So we about to run out of time, so we're going to switch gears real fast. But
we'll
that
talk
was,
about it next week.
Yeah, we can jump in off more time next week. But that was Haley's Comics.
Hey, tune in, call in next week so we can get some listeners.
All right.
Great subject, Haley.
All right, what we're going to do, we're going to jump off into these crazy eights real fast before we switch over to
bring
triple.
Bring them on, brother.
All right, the top eight signs you've been out of work too long.
Oh, Lord.
Number eight, when your neighbor gets up to start their car to go to work and you call the police because they woke you up, you've been out of work too long. Number seven, when you read the want ads and it says send in your resume and you ask, what do resume means? You've been out of work. you've been out of work too damn long. Top eight signs you've been out of work too long. Number six, when you get up in the morning and if your coffee cup is filled with Hennessy and Coke, you've been out of work too long. Oh, you got some people out here that do that now. They jump up.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Get that face.
I'm going to tell this story one day about, well, this was when I was in high school. But anyway, that's another. it was funny, man, my friend. Anyway. But top 8 signs you've been out of work too long. Number 5, if you ask your kids, so when we going to bust up with that piggy bank? You know how they usually be bugging you to get into their bank. Now you bugging them. So
right, the baby.
Yeah, man, when we going to bust that open? Number 4, if you take pigs, feet, greens, and cornbread and peach cobbler to lunch instead of a sandwich, you've been out of work too long. You eating your dinner at 11 in the morning. Top 8 signs you've been out of work too long. Number 3, when you try to convince the kids there is no food in the house, in the fridge, because you are trying to help them become a model.
Oh, no.
And then what you always, did you always want a model, huh? There ain't nothing in there. Go on in there. Ain't no food in there. Go sit down. Number 2. Top 8 signs you've been out of work too long. After the interview, and they ask you, so do you have any questions? And you ask, so when do I go on vacation? You done been out of work too damn long.
Yeah, that's too long. You already go on vacation.
You've been out of work 8 months. You talking about when do you go on vacation?
Now.
Number 1 sign you've been out of work too long on payday. You are signing the front of the check instead of the back of the check. You've been out of work too damn long. It's the top 8 signs you've been out of work too damn long. All right, I got some true and false for you guys real fast. Ladies, it would usually go first, but since Longhorn is in front of a computer and he likes to cheat, we going to...
Oh, man.
You are going first, sir.
Number 1, true or false, a man goes on... GoFundMe page to raise $10 for McNuggets. Number 2, a burglar is stuck in the elevator, has to call 911. And Jay-Z and Beyonce are trying to buy the rights to the Confederate flag. Which one is false, Longhorn?
The last one. Jay-Z and Beyonce trying to buy rights to Confederate flag. That's false.
All right, that's your final answer.
That's my final answer.
How about you, Haley? Which one is a false story here? A man's go on GoFundMe page to raise $10 for McNuggets, and a burglar is stuck in the elevator and has to call 911 on himself, or Jay-Z and Beyonce trying to buy the rights to the Confederate flag?
Well, I don't like Jay-Z and Beyonce, but I will say that one is false.
All right, we 2-0 this week. Y'all got that one correct. All right, that is the false story this week. All right, let's jump into the, y'all ready for y'all big dummies? Y'all got y'all big dummies ready?
Yeah.
For this week, we're going to jump up. What about you, Longhorn? You ready for your big dummies?
Oh, yeah, I got a big dummy.
All right, hit it, Hendow.
Big dummy, big dummy, big dummy, big dummy, big dummy, big dummy.
All right, ladies first. Haley, who's your big dummy for the week?
All right, so I don't know where the woman was. I don't remember like what city it was in, but so my big dummy for the week is 25-year-old Audrey B. McComb. She was arrested last night or Friday night. For drinking. So she was pulled over by the police and they had asked her, you know, ma'am, have you been drinking? And she told them no. And her 7-year-old son said, no, mommy, yes, you have been drinking. And of course, they took her in because, one, she blew, her alcohol level was 0.237, which is 3 times the legal limit for motorists. Which is out ridiculous. 2, you driving with a kid in the car and you've been drinking. You lied to the police and the kid's like, nope, you have been drinking. She was later posted out on bond, but I just think that is so funny. Like, you lie to the cops and, you know, kids, they don't care. They'll be like, yeah, you have been drinking. The bottle's right here. But that's just so dangerous, though. These young parents do not care, man. I swear. They better get it together.
She is honest.
Yeah, they are sometimes a little too honest, but that is my big dummy for
the
week.
That's Haley's big dummy for the week. Hit it, hand down. Dummy, 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 big, big, dummy, 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 big, big, dummy. All right, Longhorn, who's your big dummy for the week?
My big dummy for the week is Russell Wilson. Big dummy. Just because of that so-called stupidity between this dude and his fiance, he's gonna let's ban his song from the stadium and in the locker room. I declare, let's ban it. I am almighty Russell Wilson of the entertainment music. Let's ban it. He's my big dummy of the week, of the century, and yes. Hit it,
hand dog. All right, here go my big dummy for the week. And it's actually here in Michigan. And I hate to get political on people, but we done had these Tea Party people here that done got caught up in a sex scandal up in Lansing. Y'all heard about that, I'm quite sure. They got kicked out. But unfortunately, and also they used the taxpayers' money to have their rendezvous and whatever. Now, both of them are married.
What?
And they don't like... Now, here go the big dummy part right here. Now, both of them are Tea Party members, right?
Uh-huh.
They don't condone gay marriage because they have morals. Really?
Wow.
You have morals and you cheating on each other's spot. For real? These are your morals? But the sad part about it is they get to run again for the same office. And you're going to have big dummies out here voting for them to put them back in.
Wow.
Yeah, that's my big
with
dummy.
That marinade.
Yeah, that's my big dummy for the week. Hit it, hand dog.
Big, big dummy, dummy, big dummy, big dummy, big, big, big.
All right, that's my big dummy for the week. Longhorn, let me ask you a quick question.
Yes.
Terrell Owens up for the Hall of Fame induction. Should he be in there?
I think he should be in there. I think T.O. should be in there. Even though he's a character and he's flamboyant, you know.
He was a locker room cancer. He destroyed every locker room he went to.
Well, at least he never banned music from it. So.
Yeah, I think
he's going to be like future spokesman. I don't know if he can be an inductee, whether or not they put him in there, but they got him up there. So, you know, if you look for numbers, his numbers does speak, you know, speaks for itself.
Yeah, he has over 15,000 yards in career reception. So the numbers do, but you know how I feel about numbers. If you don't have no ring to go with them numbers, he could have been one of the greatest wide receivers, one of them. I'm not saying he wasn't, but if he just kept his mouth shut and play like Jerry Rice did, he could have been up there. But he went in there and destroyed every quarterback that he tried to play for. I mean,
and he was too arrogant.
Yes, indeedy. So I don't know, man. I got, you know, mixed reactions on him being in the Hall of Fame.
If they go strictly by his numbers, they'll put him in there. But if they go on his attitude, his personality, they won't put him in.
This is true. You got any final words, Haley? Shout out to the peeps out there.
Shout out
to your moms, too.
Hey, Mom. Shout out to you and the fam.
Was her birthday the other day?
Yeah, her birthday. My mom's birthday was actually on Wednesday.
Yeah,
turn up.
Congratulations,
happy birthday,
moms.
Mom.
Happy B-Day. Well,
she about 25, 26.
Yep.
Your mom's 26?
Yep. We look like sisters. No, but actually, I want everybody, please, please, please show us some love on our Facebook page at Detroit Sports Jersey 313. Also, follow us on Instagram. We need all the followers we can get at Detroit Sports Jersey. And also, make sure you guys tune in every Sunday at 11 on 88.1 WHVR.
And obviously, nobody wants no free pizza there.
Clearly, y'all know y'all like hot and ready's. And y'all know y'all could use one.
And that $100 for your Super Bowl party,
hey,
too. $100 cash money for your Super Bowl party.
Okay.
I mean, I know people going to be throwing suit. Actually, I'm giving one, too, this year again.
Okay.
Yeah. I didn't get one last year. I gave one 2 years in a row, but I didn't get one last year. I'm giving one this year, though. Yeah, I think, yeah. No. Yeah, I'm going to do it. Yeah. Okay. I love throwing Super Bowl parties.
Yeah.
I have fun.
Fun times.
Yes, indeedy. Longhorn, your final thoughts.
All right. Don't watch the clock. Do what it does and keep going.
All right.
I don't know what that means, people.
Prime time. Detroit Sports Jersey Media time, and I'm gone.
All right, once again, I want to say happy birthday to the Jersey girl who's obviously out there enjoying it and never shows up after Lions loss. So, yes, that was a backhand slap. Also, thank Haley Scott for her Haley comments today. And join us next week here. Thank the Longhorn. Thank Hen Dog behind the scenes.
Hey, Henry.
WHPR.
Hen Dog.
Hey.
Thanks for joining us here on 88.1 FM WHPR. Like you said, check us out on Facebook at Detroit Sports Jersey 313. Detroit Sports Jersey Media.com. I got to get that up, website updated also. I'm lacking behind.
Okay.
Man, I had a rough week this week. For real. But anyway, thanks for listeners and all the YouTube viewers who be checking our show out on online.
We
appreciate that also. But we'll see you when you see you. We out of here.
Thank you, listeners from Detroit to Central Texas, for joining us here live on Detroit Sports Jersey Media with your host, Will Sims, and co-host, Longhorn and the Jersey Girl, every Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern, right here on FM 88.1 WHPR. Visit us at DetroitSportsJersey.com. Straight sports talk. No professionals here. Have a great week.